Good morning and welcome back to GFC Visions, Growing in Friendship with Christ. Today is the 7th of September, and I have decided to do a video today on the 10 most famous religious paintings in Christian art. And so I'll be giving you a short description of the 10 that I found on a website that gives information about many great religious artworks. And since the video would be too long if I gave a description of all 10 of those artworks today, what I'll do is I'll give you those that are numbered from 6 to 10 today, and then I will give you the top 5 in a second video that I do on Wednesday, because tomorrow I'd like to do a video on the Blessed Mother, whose feast day is tomorrow, her birthday. So since today we're going to be, and Wednesday we'll be looking at artwork, I'd like to do a song about Vincent van Gogh, who, although he wasn't a religious artist, was regarded as one of the greatest painters. His lovely picture, Starry, Starry Night, was the theme of this song by Don McLean. Beautiful song. Starry, starry night. It's too high. Starry, starry night. Paint your palette blue and red. Look out on a summer's day with eyes that know the darkness in my soul. Shadows on the hills. Sketch the trees and the daffodils. Catch the breeze and the winter chills in colors on the snowy. What you tried to say to me, and how you suffered for your sanity, and how you tried to set them free. They would not listen, they did not know how. Perhaps they'll listen now. Starry, starry flowers that brightly blaze, swirling clouds in a violet haze, reflecting Vincent's eyes of china blue, colors changing hue, morning fields of amber gray, weathered faces lined with pain, are soothed beneath the artist's loving eyes. What you tried to say to me, and how you suffered for your sanity, and how you tried to set them free. They would not listen, they did not know how. Perhaps they'll listen now. For they could not love you, but still your love was true. Left inside on that starry, starry night, you took your life as lovers often do. But I could have told you, Vincent, this world was never meant for one as beautiful as you. Starry, starry night, portraits hung in empty halls. Frameless heads on nameless walls.
silver thorn of a bloody rose, lie crushed and broken on the virgin snow. Now I think I know what you tried to say to me. Now you suffer for your sanity, and now you try to set them free. They would not listen, they're not listening still. Perhaps they never will.
Put pictures of these 10 great artworks in at the end of the video. I'm not sure I can do it in the middle of making this video. I'm not quite sure how to do that. So I will, at this moment, I'm going to just give you the descriptions of the six to the 10th most famous artworks in Christian art. And then tomorrow, or on Wednesday, we'll go through the first five. Okay? So, beginning with number 10, by the way, just in general, religious art uses religious themes or motifs, usually having some recognizable moral narrative or attempting to evoke or inspire strong spiritual emotions in the viewer. In the West, religious art may be defined as any artwork which has a Christian theme. Western religious painting focuses primarily on scenes from the Old Testament or from the life of Jesus Christ. Among the most common are depictions of the Blessed Virgin Mary holding the child Jesus, the infant Jesus, or Christ on the cross, on the crucifix. Many of the most famous religious artworks were created during the period called the Renaissance, which is an influential cultural movement that originated in Italy during the late 15th century and lasted until the middle or the end of the 17th century. The three great masters of the Renaissance are Leonardo da Vinci, Michelangelo, and Raphael, whose works we will be looking at more a little later. So today I'd like to present what are recognized as the 10 most celebrated religious paintings in the world. Christian religious art in the world. And we'll begin with number 10. Number 10 is the Transfiguration by Raphael, which was painted in the year 1520. This was Raphael's last painting, and it's divided into two parts, the upper half depicting Christ hovering in the air, and he's dressed in flowing white robes, and he's bathed in white light. Moses and Elijah are pictured on his right and his left. The lower portion of the picture, the apostles are unsuccessfully trying to drive demons out of a possessed boy. And the painting it can also be said to depict the contrast between God and man, where the upper part is pure and symmetrical, and the lower part is dark and chaotic, symbolizing, of course, our weak human condition. And just out of curiosity, the French leader Napoleon considered Raphael to be the greatest of all the Italian artists, and this as his greatest work. The next, the ninth most famous artwork in Christian art is the famous picture by Salvador Dali, called The Christ of St. John of the Cross, which he painted in 1951. And it was based on a drawing by St. John of the Cross, the 16th century Spanish Carmelite. And the work consists of two basic shapes, a triangle, which was formed by the arms of Christ and the horizontal beam of the cross, and a circle, which is formed by the head of Christ. So the triangle can be seen as a reference to the Holy Trinity, and while the circle may be represent unity, the unity of God and his creation. Though it is a representation of the crucifixion, It is void of nails and blood. According to Dali, the inspiration for this painting came to him through a cosmic dream, and he was convinced that nails and blood would mar his particular portrayal of Christ. It is one of Dali's most famous works and is considered by many to be the greatest religious painting of the 20th century. Number eight is a painting called The Angelus by a French painter named Jean-François Millet, and it was painted in the year 1859. He was a leading artist of what was called the French Realism Movement, which sought to portray people and situations of the present with uncompromising accuracy. In his works, Millet is famous for his depictions of peasants, poor farming people. And this particular painting shows two peasants bowing their heads in the field to say the Angelus at the end of a day's work. A church can be seen on the horizon in the background, and it is the ringing of the Angelus bell from the church that has led the peasants to stop their work and to recite the prayer. This work was one of the most widely reproduced religious paintings of the 19th century. Number seven is a painting called The Burial of the Count of Orgaz, and it was painted over the years 1586 to 1588 by a very famous Spanish artist of that period named El Greco. I won't go too deeply into the religious significance of this particular painting, but it is universally regarded as El Greco's greatest masterpiece and perhaps the most famous religious painting of the Spanish Renaissance. And then lastly, for today, we'll look at number six, which is the Sistine Madonna, which was painted by Raphael in the year 1512. And it's probably his most famous depiction of the Madonna holding the Christ child. Raphael is known for his great clarity of form, the serenity, harmony, and perfection of his works, and for their visual brilliance and amazing use of color. In this work, Our Lady is holding the Christ child, and on either side of her are Pope Saint Sixtus and Saint Barbara. Beneath Our Blessed Lady are two winged cherubs, which are angels, little angels, which are perhaps the most famous cherubs depicted in any piece of religious art. And the Sistine Madonna is considered one of the finest paintings in the entire world, and is especially popular in Germany, where the work has been called divine. Well, I'm running out of time for today, so I'll just say one Our Father, one Hail Mary, and one Glory Be for you and all those who've asked for your prayers and for the intentions of the Holy Father. In the name of the Father, Son, Holy Spirit, Amen. Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, a world without end. Amen. O Mary, conceived without sin, pray for us who have recourse to thee. Okay. Laudate omnes gentes, laudate Domino, laudate omnes gentes, laudate Domino, laudate omnes gentes, laudate Domino, laudate omnes gentes, laudate Domino. for watching GFC Visions Growing in Friendship with Christ. Tomorrow we'll do a video on the Blessed Virgin Mary, and then on Wednesday I'll give to the second part of this video of the top five most famous artworks in Christian religious art. Thank you for watching GFC Visions Growing in Friendship with Christ.